When I said in December that year 2023 will be life-changing, I should be more specific. Just a little recap of what happened until now. On my first trip of the year in January, I felt like I'm losing my energy and losing myself, and then been told me that I have a cancer. So I went to Scotland, digest my new life challenge, appreciate the present moment, and prepare myself for another kind of journey. I have surgery 24 hours later after I arrived from Scotland. I received so much support and good vibes from everywhere, which I'm grateful from deepest of my heart. But, you know, as they said, you are surrounded by thousand souls, but you feeling still alone. I was feeling alone inside. I couldn't find my empathy for myself, for the wound inside of my body. Although there were friends around me, it was hard for my ego asking for a little help. When I was until now living independently 10 years, suddenly I was dependent. The only thing what I could do was just thinking. So I made a choice. What I choose to think right now. Thoughts that will make me happy, good, and doing stuff that make me happy. I learned something from my cat. Cats are happy, relaxed, and content by default. And I also made a choice of slow living. I decided to live in accordance with the natural flow of universe, so my life will be more peaceful and effortless. Slow living encourages you to prioritize what truly matters and take time to digest it. Simplifying one's life and savoring present moment. By slowing down, I could be more with my own inner self. I was trying to understand my own suffering, bringing compassion for myself, with deep silence inside me and around me. I had removed 18 lymph nodes up to my neck and a part of my breast tissue. First 7 days, I had drains. And I had a cut only on my breast, so I couldn't really imagine how the operation was done through my breast up to my neck. I was trying to find balance and harmony in my life, rather than constantly striving for more. So I've been finding a pleasure and fulfillment in silence and art, philosophy and nature. Nature doesn't hurry. Everything is accomplished. Accomplishment doesn't require speed. It takes years to a little acorn to grow to a very strong oak tree. Often my thoughts been going in a circles, carrying views and energy feelings of facing my own mortality. I found my own quiet space inside me, so I can learn more about myself. I unplugged from technology, cultivating mindfulness, meditation, and yoga. And my mind came around, which gave me lots of power to heal. Problems are opportunity for us become stronger, wiser, and obtain a more robust perspective of all things. Perspective is the way how we perceive the world, your expectations, your values, and your current state of mind has everything to do with perspective. When you have a growing mindset, your perspective on what other perceives as a problem, you see as an opportunity. Every time you face something, you are being exposed to new challenge. It tells you it's a chance to grow. Why we need to accept every challenge for the sake of growing? Because growing is the opposite of decreasing and closing. To grow, to open up, is the same as bringing light into the things. It doesn't matter what challenge it is fundamental principle behind that you don't run away, that you are open to everything that being thrown on you. I take what comes. If it leaves, I let it pass. It was weeks of mental war when results from CT showed known metastatic cancer. So then everybody cried, but from happiness, and everybody laughed. And with coming spring, my power was coming back, although my right arm was still not fully mobile. They said I'm a warrior. Warrior is expression to don't give up when the time's getting hard. Warriors keep going. You need courage, discipline, willpower to keep going and going, even after you fail so many times. Because of the failures, because there is a something inside of you which feels that you don't want to fail 4th, 5th, and 6th times anymore. Because of what that something inside you, you become very strong. So I went to my first trip to a place where all my previous adventures began. We shall not cease from exploration. At the end of all our exploring will be to arrive where we started and know the place for the first time. Through the unknown, remember the gate when the last of Earth left to discover.
March. Hello, happy beautiful March to everyone. Hello from old Roar Gill. We are in the heart of Hastings, surprisingly. This beautiful location is situated in the middle of the Hastings. So today is my first day, very first day with my small backpack, and it feels amazing. It feels honestly like I never ever been before on a walk, and this is the first time. So today is about 35 days after my surgery. As you probably hear, I had removed 18 lymph nodes, and yesterday I had my results from CT scan and lungs and the bones, if my cancer is metastatic, and the results been good. No cancer in my lungs, no cancer in my bones, but I have about 4 weeks, or 4 weeks, but I have about 4 months of chemotherapy, radiotherapy, another surgery, and maybe 10 years of hormonal medication. But yeah, it feels amazing to be outside again. So yeah, this is the life of me right now. It was very hard whole month, more mentally than with my body, I didn't feel that bad. I would like to say massive thank you from deepest of my heart to everyone who sent me wishes, pray for me, send me good vibes, because all of that was just sharing a positive energy and healing energy towards me. So each one wish has more power than you can imagine, and I'm more than 100% sure that all your wishes help me with this fast recovery, although I'm experiencing this axillary web syndrome. So pretty much I still can't lift my arm overhead and to the side. The muscles under my armpit get shorter, and basically nobody knows why this thing is happening. Apparently it's caused by trauma from the muscles. So I did check how actually looks this kind of surgery and how it's done, and although I have a cut only on the side of my boob, basically they took the lymph nodes over up here, and I couldn't really imagine how from the hole on the boob. So I did watch on the YouTube video how the lumpectomy looks like, and basically they take everything out. Why I did it? To have a better empathy and better understanding for the muscles and my arm, and think about that my body experienced trauma. I never had a surgery before, and although I was put in a sleep, my muscles being awake. So now imagine then you've been cut open, suddenly pull out from you, cut like a grapes, and put back. And I've noticed that first week after the surgery, I was basically slouching to the side, and I was scared even more because I can't really imagine what was done under my armpit. And then when basically I found out that I have this coating thing under my armpit, I started to get really sad and depressed that it's gonna take even longer to put the backpack on. So yeah, I did push on, and I did the hard work, and I was proud on myself. It's not end yet, and today my backpack on made me so happy. Yesterday results made me so happy. So now I just have to do, the 4 months chemo, and I've been approved by my oncologist hike, but they are not really happy with the wild camping, although I'll attempt to do it. I set up for myself a hardcore plan how to keep myself active during chemotherapy, and basically sweat out all the chemicals out from my body. And I do believe that I will be able to do it. I think what was most hardest thing on the last month was the fact that I was not able to do anything really. And because I'm a really independent person and I live on my own in the UK 10 years, I just not used to ask for the help with the little things, and I just was not able to even wash my hair. I had for about 1 week drains from my body, and my mom, she came over and she helped me, but the first days were so tough to do the daily jobs, like wash my teeth, everything was achy. And I must admit that in my life I experienced much worse pain with my teeth and my toothache. I think that was the most horrible pain I ever had, but it was just more mental, if that makes sense. I couldn't really paint, I couldn't go out, because when I was cold my muscles been tensing and it hurts. So it was really hard to wait for the results if the cancer is metastatic, and you know, you have this thought like, what if it's, and how long I'm gonna live, and you suddenly are thirsty for life. that's a whole story. So next week. So the next week is starting my chemotherapy, and it's very difficult for me because I truly believe that you can heal the cancer alternative way, not the chemical way, and like sound therapy. Certain frequency of sounds can break the cancer cells, and with acupuncture and different kind of stuff, but it's not really supported here. So that's why I was not really happy to put a chemical and basically poison my body. But I'm working on this as well, and I believe in the placebo effect. Oh! And I believe that exists a placebo effect, so I'm just gonna pretend that I'm gonna receive a magical red pill from the matrix. And I'm gonna receive every 2 weeks some kind of superpowers. I think it's all in the mind, all stuff. Like, you just have to keep yourself busy, and if you think about it, it's unbalanced hormones. Well, yeah, that basically what's caused my cancer, but I have a hormonal disorder. So, you know, they keep telling you, like, you're gonna feel weak, you're gonna feel sick, you don't wanna really get out. And I really don't wanna admit this, you know? I don't know how I'm gonna feel, how it's gonna be in my body, so I decided that I will try to go for a run every morning. And I will attempt to do some hikes and some simulation camping in my lounge room. I know it's not gonna be the same probably, but I'm gonna give it a try. And yeah, hopefully I will see you from somewhere. I was thinking to do 4 waterfalls, Brecon's Beacon and Exmoor's. And if everything goes all right, then maybe in August I will head off to Norway. I will be absolutely brilliant. So, yes, I'm alive, I'm happy, I miss you all, I miss the hikes. And thank you again to everyone. Thank you to my patrons, Dave, Johnny, Clark, Andrew. Thank you to Rob, Ali, thank you to my parents, thank you Michelle and Marcus again. Thank you AJ for looking after me and giving me extreme massages.
I went to the woods because I wished to live deliberately, to front only the essential facts of life, and see if I could not learn what it had to teach, and not, when I came to die, discover that I had not lived. Henry David Thoreau. Learn to die while you are alive, because you will ultimately return. All of us have a return trip